day is long.
In my 25-year career as a clinical psychologist, I've never seen a case as serious as this. He has advanced obsessive compulsive disorder with Shakerism.
It's not easy working with this kind of thing, but we make it work.
Well, the problem's getting so bad now that Shaker is introduced to the bar. If Dim hasn't had time to really acquaint himself with the Shaker, he reacts very violently.
He has to sort of go through this whole spiritual little ceremony where he welcomes it in and he accepts it into his life, and it's very strange, but you know, the worst thing we can do here is judge him on it. He's got a condition, and you know, we're all here to support him in this.
Are you a fan of the Japanese hard shake?
Inefficient, over dilution. My mum used to shake me when I was a baby.
Dim now has a restraining order on him. He's not allowed within 100 metres of any antique stores, just in case there could be any shakers in there.
What about the Harlem Shake?
A few weeks ago, someone brought in a shaker and they thought he had done the process with it, the welcoming process. He hadn't. Dim saw it and it did not end well.
Get out of here! I'm going to shake it! Give me the shaker!
Reacted so violently, I was really scared for him. I think there is a way out of it for him. I think slowly but surely we can bring him back to reality, get him not to think about his shakers all the time. And look, I think there's hope for him, and I really hope that as a young man with his condition, that we can bring him back to reality. Because right now he's very seriously lost.